Well, time and time again, the Lightning refuse to respond to stressful situations by pushing the panic button. That's just not their style of hockey. And we got a good look at that resiliency once again as the Bolts hosted the Minnesota Wild tonight. All the action happening in the final 3 minutes of the game. Middle of your screen, number 21, Braden Point. He finds a gap. Nice pass to Dan Girardi. Right place, right time for the defenseman. And he taps it on in. Bolts on the board with 2:42 remaining in the game. Less than a minute later, Tyler Johnson, he fires it. It hits the post here and goes in. A quick turn of events for the Lightning, who go up 2-0. And then Nikita Kucherov, he taps in the empty netter here. Lightning win 3-0 ahead of the Christmas break. Andrei Vasilevsky, he posts his fourth shutout of the season. And here's Girardi now on the frustration of a scoreless game and late into it.
We kept preaching after the second, you know, just stay the course, don't change anything. We just kept coming shift after shift. Obviously our PK's been struggling lately, there's no secret, but I think it came up big tonight for us. Yeah, it's definitely nice to get rewarded. I try to do a good job in my D-zone, block shots, hit guys, you know, move the puck up to our forward group, and obviously to pop one here and there is a great, and obviously nice assist in the empty netter. I'll take that all day.
Well, two consecutive years in a row, the USF Bulls played in the Birmingham Bowl, and both years they walk away with a win, wrapping up the season with double-digit wins. It's a far cry from where this program was just a few years ago. Today, USF facing Texas Tech in the Birmingham Bowl, Bulls trailing late in the second quarter, Red Raiders punting, and they give the Bulls an early Christmas present here. This punt goes just 15 yards and puts USF in an extremely advantageous situation. Two plays into the drive, Quinton Flowers finds Tyree McCants for the score here. USF and Texas Tech tied at 10 at the break. Skip ahead to the fourth quarter now. Bulls down by 3, and Flowers throws an absolute bomb to Marquez Valdez-Scantling, 64 yards for the score as the Bulls retake the lead 31-27. Ensuing drive, Red Raiders' Nick Szymanek hits a wide-open T.J. Vasher to steal back the lead once more with just over a minute to go in the game, 34-31, Texas Tech. Plenty of time for Flowers to work his magic one more time, and with 21 seconds left on the clock, Flowers again finds McCants on this 26-yard touchdown pass. USF, two-time winners at the Birmingham Bowl, 38-34 the final score. Head coach Charlie Strong leads his team to 10 wins in his first season at USF.
No, I always think about the journey, and this has been an unbelievable journey this whole season. You know, we started off and everyone thought we was going to go undefeated, go win a conference championship, had a few stumbling blocks. But the thing about it, this is a very resilient group of guys. You see today, been down, what, five times I think we had to come back and go win this football game. But when you look at, when you have a group of seniors and they're very unselfish and they don't worry about who gets the credit and it's all about the team, then you're going to have success.
And with their postseason hopes dashed weeks ago, the Buccaneers head to Charlotte to play the role of spoiler. A Panthers win over the Bucs would give Carolina a spot in the playoffs, but the Bucs say they still have a lot to play for, including their first division win of 2017. But in order to do that, head coach Dirk Cutter says the Bucs have to find a way to stop Panthers quarterback Cam Newton.
We got to remember, 2 years ago he was the MVP of the league, and you know, I know there's been some injuries or whatever, but it seems to me like he's playing at an extremely high level again. They've got a different cast around him. They built more through their running backs now, and with Olsen back, a different set of wide receivers now than he had, but it still all goes through him.
And the Bucs performance Monday raised eyebrows of what could have been this season. They have the players, but it's the injuries that just kept them from what was expected to be a year that took them back to the playoffs. Pride may be the only thing on the line for the Bucs Sunday, but the Panthers aren't expecting to just walk all over them.
Tampa's not going to come in here and lay down. I promise you that much. They got too many good football players. They got a lot of pride. They're coming to play hard, and our guys are going to play hard as well. I mean, we have a little bit more riding on it, but you know, for them, you know, they're playing to show that they're a good football team. So we've got to answer their challenge.
And Saturday Night Football, Colts at Ravens. Baltimore 2 wins away from a playoff berth, entering the game 3 minutes until the end of this one. Ravens up a touchdown, and they're punting. Colts' Anthony Walker comes up with the huge block here, and the ball is recovered at the Ravens' 27-yard line. Colts with some good field position late. And then on the ensuing drive, 4-10, Jacoby Brissett with the strike here intended for T.Y. Hilton. And it's knocked down big time. John Harbaugh, obviously excited about that. Baltimore survives the late game scare to stay alive for an AFC wildcard playoff spot. 23-16, the final. And Minnesota and Green Bay playing right now at last check in the fourth. Vikings leading 13-0. Guys.